Hello kids, today we are going to revise the lesson Adaptation in Plants and Air, Water and Weather. Today we are going to revise the lesson and revise the exercise too. So, Adaptation in Plants lesson, Adaptation in Plant lesson, we learned meaning of habitat and adaptation. Adaptation for habitat, food and self-protection. Understood now? In this lesson, we learned about meaning of habitat and the adaptation. Adaptation for habitat, food and self-protection. So, we revise the lesson, okay? Animals, let us revise. Point 1, animals adapt to their natural habitat and environment for their survival. Animals can be classified into terrestrial animals, aquatic animals, amphibians, aerial animals and arboreal animals according to their habitat. Animals can be classified into carnivores, omnivores, herbivores according to the food of their eat. Their body parts and colors to adapt to their natural habitat. Animals adapt to their natural habitat and environment of their survival. Animals, their body part and the colors to adapt to their natural habitat. Animals can classified into three types: carnivores, omnivores, herbivores according to the food they eat. And animals can be classified into terrestrial animals, aquatic animals, amphibians, aerial animals, arboreal animals according to their habitats. Animals are classified according to their habitat and according to their food. Understood, no kids? Okay, now we are going to revise the exercise. Fill in the blanks by selecting the correct option from those given in the bracket. A. Already we filled it, just we are going to revise. Okay? Terrestrial. Which word you filled here? Aerial, arboreal, terrestrial, three words are there. We filled it by a terrestrial animals predominantly or entirely live on land. Terrestrial animals predominantly or entirely live on land. Next, B. Options are air, land, water. We filled it by water. Water is natural habitat of fish. Yes, correct. C. Options, peacock, emu, eagle. Emu is a flightless bird. Yes, emu is a flightless bird. D. Options, eagle, flamingo, ostrich. Flamingo is a migratory bird. Yes, correct. Flamingos are migratory birds. E. Animals that eat both plants and animals are called omnivorous animals. Animals, those eat only plants are called herbivores. And animals that, those are eat only animal, they are called carnivores. And animals that eat both plants and animals, they are called the omnivores. Okay, kids. Now next, question number 2, circle the odd one from each set. We already circled it, okay? Just we are going to revise. A. Koala bear, crow, chameleon and lizard. We circled here chameleon. B. Toad, salamander, frog, octopus. We circled here. Octopus, toad, salamander, frog, is that the types of frog? Next, toad, these are salamander, frog are amphibians. Octopus is the water animal. It is the aquatic animal. See, penguin, kiwi, ostrich, eagle. They all are penguin, kiwi, the ostrich, all are flightless, means heavyweight birds. Eagle is a flying bird. These birds are called the flightless birds. Polar bear, horse, goat, deer. Polar bear circled here. Horse, goat, deer. Okay, in this one, polar bear circle. This type you circle the words. Next question, tick the correct statement and cross the wrong ones. A. All birds can fly. Wrong. Some birds can't fly. They are heavy birds, means their weights are more. So flightless birds are also there. B. Bat is a bird. No. Bat is not a bird. It's a mammal. Aerial animals stay in the air all the times. Wrong. Frog hibernate in water. Yes, correct. Snakes swallow their prey fully. Yes, correct. This type you revise the fill in the blanks, true or false, circle the word, odd word. Okay, next we are going to revise the question answers. Answer the following questions. Question A. Why do polar bears have thick fur? Answer. The polar bear that live in extremely cold polar region has very thick fur which protect it from extreme cold. Understood, my kids? Next, second question. Camel is the most suitable animal for the desert region. Explain. Answer. Camel lives in the hot, dry desert. Its a long leg keep the body away from the hot sand, while its a thick lip and tongue help it to eat the thorny bushes found in deserts. The camel's hump is a storehouse of fat that it uses when it does not get any food or water for day on end. Okay, now next question, question C. Why do monkey have long, strong, curly tails? Answer. Monkey live on tree most of the time. Monkey have long, strong tail with which they can swing from branches to branches of trees. Question D. Why do some animals hibernate? There are answer. There are some animals that become inactive during the harsh winter, severely hot summer. Animals like bats and squirrel, mice, bears sleep through the winter. Since their bodies are unable to adjust to the extremely low temperature, so some animals hibernate. Now last question, why do some animals and birds migrate? Answer is, in certain season, animals and birds migrate in order to breed, find out food, avoid the extreme cold conditions, weather. Understood, the kids? Here, the question answers also over. Now, question number 5. Give reason for the following. A belly is different for a fish. Why? You may answer. bellies are different for the fish. Answer: belly also live in water but comes up to the surface to breathe because they use their lungs and not gills for breathing. Understood, no? Fishes use their bills for breathing. Bellies are use their lungs for breathing. So bellies are different from fish. Next question. Arunathai with her family is migrating to Delhi from Kolhapur. This migration is the different from the migration of the flamingos? Yes. Arunathai with her family is migrating to Delhi from Kolhapur. This migration is different from the migration of the flamingos because the flamingo migrate in order to breed, find food and avoid the extreme cold weather. Okay, kids, here are lesson and exercise revision over. Now we are going to revise the next lesson, air, water and weather. In this lesson, we learned weather and climate, factors causing change in weather, changes in temperature, movement of air, sea breeze, land breeze, states of water, rain and water cycle, water pollution and water purification. These all points we are learned in this lesson. So let us revise the lesson in some points. The condition of the atmosphere around us at a particular time is called the weather. The condition of the atmosphere around us at a particular time is called the weather. 2. The changes in the weather due to the heat of the sun, movement of the air and the changes in the water present on the earth. The changes in the weather due to the heat of the sun, momentum of the air and changes in the water present on the earth. Next, hot air becomes lighter and rises. The sea breeze and the land breeze occur due fast heating the and cooling of the land as compared to water. The process of the evaporation and the condensation of water that goes in nature in cycle of manner is called the water cycle. Water pollution destroys the environment and also causes several diseases in animals and plants. We must not waste water. Hot air becomes light and rise up. Cold air become a heavy and comes down, settle down. The sea breeze and the land breeze occur due to the fast heating and cooling of the land as compared to the water. The process of evaporation, condensation of water that goes on in nature and in cycle manner, that is called the water cycle. Water pollution destroys the environment and also causes several diseases in animal and plant, those are present in environment. We must not waste the water. We should use the water properly. We save the water. Understood, no kids? Okay, now we are going to revise the exercise. Fill in the blanks by selecting the correct options from those given in the bracket. 1. A. The condition of the atmosphere around us at a particular time is called the weather. Just we are revised. Okay? Answer is weather. B. Snow is the... It's a solid, liquid or gaseous form of water? Solid form of water. C. The process by which a liquid changes into a gaseous state is called the evaporation. The process by which liquid changes into gaseous, that is called the evaporation. D. Snowflakes appears in different shapes for form and are soft and light. Snowflakes appears in different shapes, forms and are soft and light. Okay. Now, E. During filtration, solid, answer is solid, impurities are trapped on the filter candle. During the filtration, solid impurities are trapped on the filter candle. Okay. Now, kids, question number 2. Look here. Change the underlined word to correct the statement. Change the underlined word to correct the statement. A. A fast moving, underlined word is fast moving, wind is called a breeze. Remove this one fast moving word and put here gentle. Which word? A gentle wind is called the breeze. B. Mist is a thick cloud at ground level. Fog. Instead of mist, we write here by fog. Fog is a thick cloud at ground level. C. The water vapor in the air freezes and turn into water. No. Snowflakes. Answer is snowflakes. Remove the water and write here snowflakes. D. Purifying water by filtration kills the diseases causing bacteria. No. Chlorination. Purifying water by chlorination kills the diseases causes bacteria. Remove the filtration. Put here chlorination. Next, E. The process of transferring the clear liquid without disturbing the sediment is called the sedimentation. No, decantation. That is called decantation. Understood? No, kids. Here are change the underlined words to write the correct statement. Over. Now, next question. Question number 3. A. Explain land breeze. Answer is, the land cools down faster than the water. The air above the sea is still warm and therefore rises up. The cool air from the land rushes towards the sea to take its place. This is called the land breeze. Understood, no, kids? Okay, next one. What is the difference between the dew and frost? On a winter morning, we often notice little droplet of water on leaves and flower or any object left outside in the open area. This happens because the water vapor in the air around these objects condenses naturally and settles on their cold surface in the form of droplets. These droplets are called the dew. In extremely low temperature, dew drops freezes and turns into icy crystals called the frosts. Okay, now next question. Why do we see fog during the winter season? Answer. A dense mist is called the fog. It is formed when a lot of water vapor condenses and dust particles in cold air. Fog forms during the winter when temperature falls a very low level. Next question D. How does water get polluted? By throwing harmful substances into water, directly or indirectly, water gets polluted. Question E. Why do we feel cool air and seashore even during hot summer days? Answer. Sea breezes occurs during hot summer days because of the unequal heating rates unequal heating rates of the land and water. During the day, the land surface heats up faster than the water surface, so that we feel cool air at seashore during the hot summer days. Okay, kids, here are two lesson division, exercise revision over. Today's your homework is you read the lesson by the question answers. Thank you for watching the video.